This is not a video any sane person would make. But guess what? We're not like the rest. Hi guys. This video will probably go down in the history of this channel as the least watched video we've ever made. Wanna know why? Because most people either don't care or don't even understand what the heck I'm talking about. Honestly, I didn't know it was a problem either until I ran into it myself. A few years ago, I was building my first 5-axis CNC machine. That's when it happened. The curse. I even made a video about the chaos back then, and just like it was cursed, the views never went up. This video, yeah, it's that kind of video again.
Freak, what are you doing?
Hi, Angel. I was just about to tell a terrifying story about a curse.
Wait, this thumbnail, isn't this that old video you posted ages ago? The one about noises. That totally flopped. Why is it still up? You should just delete this disaster already.
Hey, hey. I'm trying to make the story sound interesting. Don't go blurting out noise problems right away.
Don't tell me you're making another noise video. Are you insane? It's gonna get like 10 views. Max.
But this is important. A lot of people who try to build CNC machines with big motors eventually run into this problem. Even if only 10 people watch this video, I'm gonna give it everything I've got.
You really are an idiot. Do you even realize how much time you're wasting making this stupid video? What a waste of time. Well, not my time, anyway.
That's not true. Even if it's just 10 people, if even one of them is helped by this, that's enough for me. When I get a comment saying, thanks, or freak, you're a genius, or freak, you're so handsome, or maybe freak, you're a genius, it makes me happy. Some people might even want to send a super thanks. But me? I don't ask for that.
Hey freak, did you notice you said freak is a genius twice? You really live in your own little world, huh? Must be nice, being so clueless. I mean, aren't you terrible at electronics anyway?
Angel, just because you're bad at electronics doesn't mean I am. Don't project your weaknesses onto me. Anyway, let's get started. First, I'll explain what actually happened.
So, what did you do about it?
I gave up, drank some whiskey, and went to bed.
You've got to be kidding me.
Oh, come on. It's not like more than 10 people are gonna watch this anyway.
Not with that attitude. No one's gonna give you a super thanks like this.
All right. I'll do my best. First, take a look at this. When I power on the spindle VFD, the motor starts moving by itself. Now, I had already done some noise countermeasures, but the motor still moved on its own.
Wait, what even is noise? And why would it make the motor move like that?
Let me explain. When you build your own CNC machine, you run into all sorts of problems, right? And sometimes, those problems pile up. So much that you want to smash the machine. That hatred, it manifests as noise. And that's what makes the motor move.
Shut up. Don't say another word. You're not gonna explain it properly anyway. Just fire up Ultimate already.
All right. I'll activate my greatest creation, the Ultimate AI. Ultimate.
Hey, Auntie Angel. Thanks for calling me up. But you know, if you keep frowning like that, you're gonna get even more wrinkles. Honestly, you're starting to look more like a demon than an angel.
You shut up too. Now I'm really getting pissed. Maybe I should tweak your parameters and teach you some manners.
Hello, lovely angel. You're always so radiant. When I grow up,
I hope I can become just like you. A perfect blend of beauty and brilliance.
Perfect tuning, if I do say so myself. This girl is so honest now. Just the way I like it.
This is Angel's curse. This whole video is spinning out of control because of Angel's noise.
Shut up. Say one more word, and I'll drink all your whiskey.
No. Hey, anything but that.
Ultimate, could you explain what noise really is?
Of course, my radiant angel. In electronics, noise refers to unwanted electrical signals that interfere with proper operation. It's like static that sneaks into your circuits, messing with data, triggering false signals, or causing devices to behave strangely. In CNC machines, noise can come from many sources, like VFDs, motors, or even power cables. For example, when the spindle VFD turns on, it can emit high-frequency signals that sneak into your control lines and make stepper motors jitter or limit switches misfire. That's why we need noise countermeasures, such as grounding, shielding, ferrite cores, and signal isolation. Because even the tiniest ghost signal can haunt your machine.
Unlike Freak, that was a perfect explanation.
Hey, I was gonna say the same thing. The key is grounding, shielding, and ferrite cores. Ultimate didn't mention it, but this time I also used a line filter.
What's that?
A line filter is something that protects your system from evil forces that try to invade through them.
Zip it. I was talking to Ultimate.
Understood, beautiful angel. A line filter, also known as an EMI filter, is a device that reduces electromagnetic interference coming through power lines. It works by blocking high-frequency noise signals from entering or exiting your system. This helps prevent malfunctions in CNC controllers, especially when devices like spindle VFDs generate electrical noise. In short, it's like a security gate. Only clean power like Angel passes through. Freaks are no good because it gets dirty.
What?
Especially the beginning and the end. Those were spot on.
I think Ultimate's explanation might have been a bit hard to follow. So let me explain it in a way that's easier to understand. So here's what I did. I installed a line filter between the household AC outlet and the spindle VFD. Then I connected the grounds of all the electronic components to the ground terminal of that line filter. By all, I mean the Raspberry Pi, the spindle VFD, the switching power supply, and the shield layers of shielded signal cables.
What are shielded signal cables? Exactly. And Freak, don't answer. Just keep your mouth shut.
Of course, the most beautiful and intelligent angel in the world. Shielded signal cables are special wires that have a metal layer around them to block unwanted electrical noise. Think of it like a tiny suit of armor, protecting the signal inside.
Ultimate, you really can't lie, can you? Your explanations are so clear. You're such a good girl. I'm sure the viewers will be so touched by your honesty, they'll send you a super thanks.
What's a super thanks? How do you do that?
Oh, it's easy. You just click here. See? That's it. Got it? Super simple, right?
Well, her explanation was nice and all, but she left out the most important part. You're supposed to connect the shield to ground on only one side. If you connect both ends, you'll create a ground loop. See? I do explain things better. Oh, and if you don't have a proper shielded cable, you can wrap aluminum tape around the wire and ground that instead. Just make sure to cover the aluminum with something so it doesn't short out. Honestly, I think my explanation was perfect. and you're wondering if there's any way to say thank you. Honestly, just knowing you appreciated it is more than enough for me. But if you really, truly feel like doing something, you can use the super thanks feature to support me. Just putting it out there, you know, just in case.
By the way, this applause and cheering you hear, totally fake. Freak, just because your views don't go up, doesn't mean you can throw in random effects like that.
Anyway, this noise problem was brutal. Since I suspected the VFD itself was generating noise, I decided to wrap everything in aluminum tape to try to kill the source of the noise. I'm not 100% sure if it really worked, but of course, all of that aluminum tape was connected to the ground of the line filter. And of course, I also added ferrite cores everywhere I could. It's kind of strange, isn't it? Just clipping on these little things, and somehow the noise problems get so much better. But honestly, they really do help.
Since Freak can't explain what ferrite cores actually do, I'll give a quick explanation. Ferrite cores are like filters for cables. They block high frequency noise by absorbing it as heat, so that the signals on the cable stay clean. They're especially useful on power lines and signal cables. When VFD noise starts causing interference, Freak, you should really be able to explain at least that much. Next time, do better, okay? I'm rooting for you.
Oh, right. I almost forgot. There's one more important fix I added. Inside the LinuxCNC HAL file, I set up a debounce filter for the limit switches. That way, all those tiny spikes and glitches from noise get completely ignored. Now, the switches only trigger when they're actually pressed. Pretty neat, huh?
What Freak is talking about is the debounce component. It adds a tiny time delay, just a few milliseconds, so that quick bursts of electrical noise don't get mistaken for real signals. Combine that with proper grounding and ferrite cores, and your CNC machine becomes much more stable.
After a lot of trial and error, I finally got it running properly. This video ended up being a bit of a joke, but honestly, if you're trying to build your own CNC machine, I think there's a lot of useful stuff in here.
And I think this time, thanks to me perfectly tuning Ultimate, the explanations were actually clear for once. Personally, I really like how honest she is. That's it for today's video. Did you enjoy it?
If you are interested in this project, I suggest you subscribe to my channel so you don't miss any videos. If you empathize with my project, why don't you become a member and support this channel? There are a few benefits, but as long as you are a member, your name will appear at the end of the videos as a patron. In other words, you can be a part of this project. So, please look forward to the next video.